Hello, how's it going? My name is Dom Whiting and I'm the Task Lord for today. Now in today's show, I'm going to be putting four contestants through some very interesting tasks, some very mind-boggling, frustrating and all round not easy at all. And they're doing this all to battle out for some fantastic prizes. Obviously excited, it's going to be an absolute blast. Now, none of the contestants have seen each other and how they've performed in these tasks, so it's all going to be revealed tonight. Very exciting. And Jonny and myself are going to be scoring these tasks. It's exciting. So by my side right here, we do have Jonny. How's it going, mate? You okay?
It's good.
It's exciting, isn't it?
It's not bad, is it? Yeah.
You've seen some of the tasks.
I've seen everything that's gone on over the past couple of weeks, and I'm going to tell you it is absolutely fantastic, and you're about to have a hell of a time. It's going to be great.
Fantastic. I'll tell you what then, let's meet our contestants. So we've got four. We've got Dave and Jordan from Demon FM.
Hello.
And we've got Jack and Bex from Tea Room. How's it going, guys? You excited for this?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
Yeah.
How was filming? Was it good?
Stressful.
You loved it?
Yeah. I mean, some of them, breeze. Some, maybe not.
It'll be interesting to see what everyone else has done.
Are any of you feeling quite competitive?
I am.
Yeah.
Very.
Yeah.
Very.
Have you been kind of chatting about it backstage?
Nah.
I don't know anything about it.
I've given the odd hint, but that's it.
Yeah. Very secretive.
Well,
Jonny, let's see the first challenge.
Let's go.
I'm confused.
Oh, hello.
Okie dokie.
Right.
Hello.
Off the envelope. Thank you. Right.
It does look a little bit like you're about to exercise the pineapple or something horrible like that, but I don't know what it is you're about to make me do.
Pop the balloon.
You cannot step inside a circle. You can't ask anyone to help. You have 10 minutes. Your time starts now. Pop the balloon. God.
What?
Oh, bollocks.
Seems simple enough.
I guess.
Okay, that's not going to cut it. Just take the envelope. Right, let's think.
Can you please pop the balloon for me?
So obviously quite an easy task to start off with there. The contestants here had to pop a balloon, which was situated inside a circle. They could not enter the circle under any circumstances. That's pretty much the gist of it.
That's very interesting. I'm looking forward to seeing what's going on.
So we've started the VT in the next one. We've gone with Jordan, Dave, and Jack. Yeah, Jordan, Dave, and Jack. That is how I split it.
Oh,
so let's so watch, see how they got on.
I just go.
Whenever you're ready.
I just go. I'm ready.
You ready?
Good. Starting. By stepping inside the circle, does that mean my feet only?
You can't enter the circle.
Can't enter the circle.
Oh. It's 1 minute, by the way.
A bit out of ideas already. Maybe I can throw a pound coin at it.
That didn't work. Around me, if I'm stuck on an island,
else is there around it? I'll just throw another shoe at it. Let's have another go. My socks are getting really wet. I hope this is good entertainment for you all, especially you. Not the pilot. Can I go in to pick the pilot?
No, you can't go in.
But it looks so sad when it's on the floor.
Nothing, not even one. Oh. Right.
I'm really cold now. Fourth, fifth time lucky, whatever time we're on.
Nice.
Yes! I am the man.
Ooh. Yes! Get in!
That's very interesting right there. So we had Jack, Jordan and Dave. Now, one thing I want to come to quickly. Jordan,
yeah.
You obviously in the VT we saw you complete it first. How did that work for you? What was your mind process? What were you thinking?
My process was arm to arm. It was quite long, so I could reach it. So used it as like a rope sort of thing, and I was then gonna get it to the edge, then get the balloon. But it turns out my jacket had like a zipper on it, and it just popped it anyway. Oh. So
what you're telling me is just more luck than anything
fluke.
Else.
Bit of a fluke. Fluke.
Bit of a fluke. Now, Dave. I've recovered this £1. Do you want it back? This
is the actual. Love that, you know.
This is the actual £1
you
threw.
I've been looking for that ever since we filmed.
Well, I've got it for you. Well, one thing I was a bit confused about is you threw one shoe.
What
made you think the second shoe would work?
If it didn't work? Sorry.
Well, the first shoe didn't work. What made you think, second shoe, that worked?
Well, I just thought, I'm going to get wet feet anyway.
Okay.
So I may as well take the second shoe off and try that one as well.
He did end the day with quite wet feet.
I did end the day with very wet feet. And I walked home with no shoes on.
And I also thought the same idea. Like, I was thinking, like, I could chuck a boot and maybe it'll work. But I was like, I'm not going to risk it.
You weren't prepared to get soggy feet.
He
was dedicated.
Yeah, much more dedicated than I was. Absolutely.
All three of you went for a quite similar approach, I think it's fair to say. Mm-hmm. What do you think? You there?
There's a reason we separated the three guys to Bex.
I did something a little bit different.
Okay.
So shall we have a watch of that?
Let's have a look at what Bex did.
Can I ask someone else to pop the balloon?
No.
But I can't step inside. Can I move this off? Can I make it square? That's not a circle anymore. Right, now I need to pop the balloon.
Nice.
Yes!
Oh, there.
No one better beat that.
Complete different approach.
So just for the record, Bex did it in 39 seconds.
39 seconds. So what about the lads on average? What do you think?
I don't think it's worth saying.
No, a bit too long.
A couple more minutes, yeah. But in the end, it is up to you to decide.
What brought you to that conclusion that you could move the circle?
I just had a moment of brilliance. I was like, I can't step inside a circle, so I'll make it a different shape. I don't know, originally I said, can I make it a square? And then I started pulling the string and I was like, wait, I don't need to make it a square, I can just move it.
Why did you want it to be a square? Was that just random?
It was just the first shape that came into my head that wasn't a circle.
Fair enough. I think it's fair to say we're going to award all 4 points there to Bex on that one for absolute
nice.
Brilliant, really. I think that's clever. I didn't even think of doing it myself like that. Well, I came up with a task. fantastic. So
who's going to get your next points then? The 3 points?
Points. So I think definitely the 3 points has to go to Jordan, simply because he came first. I think 2 points needs to go to Dave.
Thank you.
And 1 point to Jack on the end. I'm sorry, guys.
That's okay.
That's just the way I see it.
Dave put a lot of effort into it.
There's a lot of effort, a lot of commitment, but ultimately, Jordan did beat you on the time, I think. I'll give you this £1 back at the end, mate.
Thanks very much.
I'll give you that £1 back. So, on to the next task. Jonny, what do they have to do?
So the next task, a slightly harder task. This was the ping pong ball challenge. Essentially, they had to move a ping pong ball from one side of campus to the other, but I'll let the VT explain.
Hello, Jonny.
Hi, Dave. How you doing? You good?
Hello, mysterious ping pong ball.
Get the ping pong ball to the wall with the pineapple on.
Which is where? Oh.
I knew that was something, that pineapple.
You cannot touch the ball with any part of your body. You have 15 minutes, your time starts now.
Oh, okay. Right, okay.
Where's the pineapple? You're not going to tell me, are you?
Can I kick it with my foot? Does that count as a body part?
You can't touch it.
Can't touch it. Oh.
With the wall with the pineapple on, my balls are blind.
Without using my body, can I use my nose? My hair. Does that count as a body?
All right.
Okay, let's just guess this. It's fine.
Oh, fantastic. Again, another quite easy task, I'd say. I set out, I thought it was quite easy, don't you think? You don't agree?
No.
Definitely not easy.
No.
Let's watch, let's see.
So I've kind of split people up in very various ways.
Okay.
I believe we're starting with...
We've got Bex, Jordan and Jack.
Yeah. I think it's just Bex and Jack for this one. We'll see.
Surprises.
Keep with my foot. Does that count as a body part?
You can't touch it.
Can't touch it. Oh.
Let's try it.
Can I touch it with an item of clothing?
No, because you're touching it.
Right.
You're not touching it.
No, I'm not.
Oh, this isn't right. Okay. Blowing is not an option. I should have foreseen this.
Really competitive person.
Can I borrow one of you? Oh no. Can I borrow one of you, please? I just need someone to pick up this ping pong ball and take it to the other end of the room, the street.
What, the ball?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Oh, for goodness sake!
Can I borrow one of you, please? Just to pick up this ping pong ball and take it to the other end, because I can't touch it.
Where's the pineapple? Is it there?
There, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, no worries.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, I have to get it from here to the other end. It's part of the game.
Just here?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. That's...
Oh, for goodness sake!
Obviously. And I know you're doing me a massive favour. Thank you very much. Yeah. Right, okay. Awesome. Thank you. Much obliged. It's on the wall. It hit the wall. So, oh.
But you've got to make it touch the pineapple.
Oh, take some time. Oh, no. Okay, excuse me, can you help me? Can you put that ping pong ball and make it touch the pineapple for me? This ping pong ball, it's part of the game. I can't touch it. Can you make it touch the pineapple? It's part of the game, I can't touch it. Just like, roll it against the pineapple. Awesome, thank you.
Nice.
Well done.
No, it's part of the game, I'm not allowed to touch it. Thank you so much though. You made a student's day, thank you. Yes! Alright, cup of tea.
Now, immediately, I need to come to you, Jack. Very interesting that was, watching that. Because I thought halfway through, you were going to do the clever thing and get somebody else to pick it up. What happened there?
Well, I thought, yeah, I'll get someone else to pick it up. Completely didn't know. I could have just asked you to pick up. So I had to plead with people to pick up that ping pong ball. And the guy wouldn't take it all the way. He had to go to the library. So I thought, I'll cut you a deal, get me halfway, and then I can, like, get the rest there.
Fair enough. Yeah. One thing I want to pick up on is what do you call campus?
A room at one time.
I didn't know our open campus was called a room.
Yeah, it was clearly air exhaustion because I used all my oxygen on that one.
I think his mind was focusing on one thing and then.
And one thing only.
Yeah.
Pretty much. Now, Bex.
Balls.
Another pretty fantastic performance right there.
Thank you.
Obviously, not as quick as the first round. Took you a few minutes. You slammed straight into the ground.
Yeah, I wasn't, like I said, competitive. I was basically doing burpees all the way along trying to push this ball.
Yeah, the reason
along.
I put Bex and Jake together is because they did very similar techniques.
Very similar techniques. Mm-hmm. Jack, you were so grateful at the end to that guy. I thought you was going to polish his shoes.
I know, I was pleading, begging for any help because people would just give me that look. You know that look when they're like, don't talk to me. So I'm like, okay, I'll just let you go by. And so, yeah, so when that person, both those people, I was... Happy days.
Absolutely fantastic. How do you think? You think this was good? And one thing I want to pick up on is how come, was that allowed?
We'll get on to this.
I don't remember what the...
We'll get on to this.
Okay.
But...
I don't remember.
Bex and Jake, you were the middle ground, I think.
Middle ground.
Yeah, so you weren't the best, you weren't the worst. Okay. But we're now going to go on to Dave and see how he did it.
Can I find someone? Can I walk and find someone? I'm just going to try and ask someone if they'll help me move a ping pong ball to a pineapple. This probably won't go very well at all, but it's worth a shot, really, isn't it? But we're just going to test my sales skills right now. Oh, look, she knows how to approach it. Hello. Hiya. Hello. Can I borrow you? Can I use you for something? Oh, that's okay. Who am I going to find? Between lectures, and now I've got to find someone to move a ping pong ball. Nightmare. Maybe I could use something instead. What about? Can I pick one of these rocks up? Use it. I can borrow this. Hello. Would you like to do a massive favour for me?
How long
will it take? It won't take long, I promise.
Okay.
How would you feel about moving a ping pong ball to this pineapple up here for me? It would literally be 2 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
Come with me, let's go. So yeah, here's the ping pong ball. You'd just like to pick it up for me. Thank you. And then just move it down to the... I'll come with you, don't worry.
Okay.
This worked well. At first, I didn't know what to... I thought I could take my shoe off and just push it along, but that wouldn't be allowed. I thought maybe I could... I thought about getting down on the floor and just licking it along, but that's still touching.
Right.
I thought about doing everything. And
that pineapple, I see.
That pineapple there, yeah. I don't know if it's... Has it got to be on the pineapple, touching it? On just... So I'd like to just balance it.
I'll try.
On the... Onto the spike
onto
bit.
The spike.
Yeah, that's it.
I'll try.
Just onto the top there. Literally just lick... Task one, done.
Sorted. I'm going to work now.
See you later.
Bye.
Dave, an absolute brilliant performance.
Dave cottoned on very early on. You could just ask someone to take it all away.
Absolutely brilliant. But before we have a quick chat with you a little bit more about your performance, we've got, obviously, this is a charity event. We've got some fantastic charities in mind. So we're going to show you a couple of videos now and why you should be donating. Now, that VT said it better than anybody could have said. And obviously, this is a charity broadcast, and we are raising money for two fantastic charities, Mind and Coping with Cancer. And the way you can donate is by quickly opening a new tab or heading over to your internet browser and heading over to greatrugchallenge.co.uk/donate. Every single penny and pound is,
some massively appreciated. Some excellent
causes. Yeah, definitely. Excellent causes. But anyway, before those fantastic words right there by people from Mind, we watched Dave's VT. About getting a ping pong ball from the bottom of the campus to the top of the campus.
We did.
How do you think it went?
I think it went brilliant, because straight away I'm thinking about it and I'm like, oh, what if I... I'm asking Jonny all sorts of questions. Can I touch up my hair, my tongue? Probably stupid questions.
Obviously the answer was no, every time.
Can I nudge it with a rock? But that's still touching. Yeah. So,
How long did he take, can I ask?
Oh, I can't remember.
It was very, very, very short. He was the fastest. Just to put it out there, he was the fastest. Yeah.
Definitely under 5 minutes. I saw on the VT the little clock. Yeah. You're obviously proud of yourself.
Oh, I'm very proud. I just thought, why not just grab someone? I've got to admit, I was really worried at first because I was going up to all sorts of people. And as they do when you're trying to get anyone to do anything in
the
world.
Start texting and walk away.
They just walk away from you. They've got their headphones in anyway. Yeah, and it's between lectures. Mm. No one's around.
You had a right little chat with your helper way. Asking absolutely everything. And she did a fantastic job. Mm.
It's just been confirmed that you're... time was 1:09.
1:09.
And you had 15 minutes, so, yeah.
Wow. I had no idea it was that fast.
Now, hang on a second. Oh. Jordan, why are you moaning there? What's going on?
I did it very differently.
Very differently.
I think that's one way of putting it. That's one way of putting it there. Jordan, let's just watch the video.
Let's watch the video, let's go. All right. This could take forever. Don't go in the drain.
I don't like DMU's new infrastructure. Right, this has gone tits up. I've lost all my stones. I need a ramp. I'm gonna build a ramp. Casual Sunday. I want stones, not fag butts. Now, building a ramp.
Building a ramp.
Oh.
What are you doing with these?
Try and make another ramp.
It's not gonna work.
Ain't gonna work. Get out of there. This is really stressing me out. I don't like this. This is to the wall, not on the wall. Is it on the wall or to the wall?
That's it's gonna touch the pineapple.
Ah! Can't touch the ball. I can touch the pineapple.
Well then.
I don't like these games. Oh. I'm so done with ramps. Never want to see another ramp again.
Well done.
Oh, absolutely. I've got so many questions and not enough time. I was about crying through that. Ramps, what's your obsession with ramps?
Well, I had no choice, I got stuck. So I had to get out of there somehow. Like, I thought, right, I was gonna pass out, I was blowing too much. So then I was like, chuck stones at it, and then it created a bounce, and then I was stuck. I was stuck there for ages.
How long was it? Because I saw you laying down on one of the benches.
I was stuck for like...
Do you want to know, really?
I would like to know,
It was under 15 minutes, okay. So that's okay. It was only just. It was 14:48 seconds.
Jesus.
When compared to Dave's 1:09 seconds.
No one needs to know that.
Now, with the mud thing, I was thinking ramp sensible. But do you honestly think the jacket ramp was sensible at all? Be honest.
You wanted to take it off again, didn't you?
He loves dripping.
Whoa, it was getting hot outside.
I did note a lot that Jordan likes taking his clothes off a lot during challenges.
I just didn't know what else to do. And then it clicked. I can move the pineapple, which none of you lot do.
A little bit of credit for that.
It took you long enough, though.
I realised, could I have just took the pineapple all the way to the ball at the start?
Yeah. Oh, that was perfectly in the rules.
We all should have thought of that.
I know.
Fantastic.
But I didn't use anyone, so I think I deserve...
There's definitely pros
and
cons.
In the end, it's up to you. Who's you're going to give your 4 points to? Who are you going to give your three, your two, and your one?
Naturally, my 4 points has to go to Dave.
Thank you. Rather pleased.
My 1 point has to go to Jordan.
That's disgraceful.
Now, the thing is, I think coming between Jack
who
and Bex.
Who was quicker? Yeah.
Who was quicker? Now, I think what I'm going to have to say is I'm going to have to give three to Bex. So I think it was quicker and it took you less time to figure out you could actually use someone.
And I got further blowing the ball.
Now,
as
Jack,
well.
Fantastic effort, but it did take you a little bit more time to realise you could find someone. So another 2 points to you.
Even my pleading wouldn't help. Like if I did it now, please
do. No, that's it. It's on tape. That's it. It's sorted. Now we have got one final challenge, I believe.
We do.
Shall we find out what it is?
I think it's personally my favourite of them all.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Let's have a look at it. Let's have a look at the challenges.
Mysterious envelope in a room and some potatoes.
Okay. Let's have a look.
No! Does it have to be this? How?
A little bit scared. What's the taskmaster got me doing now? Get these potatoes into the wine bottle. You have 5 minutes. Your time starts now.
Whoa, okay, right. Into the wine bottle. Okay, 5 minutes, right, okay.
Is there any limitations to what I can do this time? Can I do anything? Can I smash it?
To you?
Okay. Blimey, they're huge. These are bigger than my career prospects. Right.
Now, we won't say any more about your career prospects there, Jack. But our final challenge here, Jonny, yes. Tell us what it's about, just quick, briefly.
So, if you didn't hear it there, you have to get a, well, you had to get a, as much potato as you can into a wine glass, using any means necessary. It was interesting how they did it. Some of them found some of the clues we left around. Some of them didn't, but we'll get onto that. Jordan again, yeah. I've split you sort of 50-50, so we're going to start with Bex. No, we're not, we're not.
We've got Jack and Dave.
Jack and Dave, that's the one.
An easy one to believe. Let's have a look, let's have a look.
Into the wine bowl. Let's do the classic. Okay, no, that's going to take too long. Too long.
A bit hard to smash the floor, wasn't it? Oh, a bit of potato flying there.
Perfectly
fine. That's still not going to go in, is it? Can I stamp on it?
If you want.
Can I use this? Oh god, this is gonna be a mess. Oh god, no, that did not work. Oh god.
That's a start, maybe. Yes. 30 seconds, one little bit.
Well, that's stuck. Aha. Right. Well, that's it.
Maybe it's just hair. That worked better than smashing it up, to be honest.
Oh, that's still. Oh, into the wine bowl. How the. That is. Okay, that. I need to get clever with this one. And that's not going to help. Okay, wait.
Can I, like, chuck it against the whiteboard?
If you want to.
No, actually, I might make a lot of noise.
I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm thinking I've been faced with these three obstacles and I have no idea how to... Oh, this is clever. Right, okay. Peel three of these. Oh, my... Wait, no, hang on. I think this is a red herring.
That's 3 minutes.
Oh. Okay.
Now I'm covered in potato. Oh, yes, that satisfying sound of potato squelching.
Oh, all this water's just flying everywhere. Okay, hang on. That's potato. Right, get in. Like a toddler trying to like work magic.
It's just not going well, is it? At all. 3 minutes.
3 minutes to go.
Why can you add 15 minutes to this one?
It's not particularly difficult.
Is it not?
No.
Is there a masher in the room or something? I've not looked around at all, have I? That. Has anyone got a peeler?
Okay. Get in! Oh. Right, I've got some potato. Is that... No, hold on.
Oh my god, there's a bloody hammer tied to the thing! Yeah.
I'm going, please. Oh no, it's stuck. I need.
You've got 2 minutes left.
Okay. Okay. Oh, all this water's just flying everywhere. Okay, hang on. That's potato, right, get in.
How am I supposed to get two potatoes in a wine bottle in 1 minute and 42 seconds? I'm gonna hit my own foot in a minute. Yes. This one's going in now. 1 minute 20. Oh, he's got a peel on his leg! Oh my god! What's that gonna do though? What am I gonna do? Peel some skin off. Oh, I hate you.
10 seconds. Just sort of make it look good.
Yes. Come on. Does it count? Is it like that? Just what, stuff it at the top. I'm going to say yes. But it's all interpretations.
20 seconds.
Ah! Then let's do this. Use that bit. Oh, that doesn't work. I'm just enjoying the distraction, to be honest.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Potato wedge. I call it art. Live art.
Well done.
Thank you. Alright, I'm just gonna. There's a lot of water in these. Little water balloons.
Probably a bit like you then.
Yeah, very much so.
Again, too many questions for you there, Jack. Very interesting. You were begging the bottle to let potato go inside. What was that all about?
Well, I thought it was like a magic trick, like, you know, when they magic get like the coins and stuff in, but clearly not.
Now, before we discuss these properly, we're gonna head over and now watch Jordan's and Bex.
Very different technique.
Yeah. Let's have a quick look.
Did you write that? Can I spin it round? Is that part of it, or is it really?
This ain't gonna be done in 5 minutes.
Oh, yes! Can I rub it out for when Jack comes in? Oh! Right, so it needs to be like every little bit.
What are you thinking about this technique that you're doing now? I'm thinking it'll work eventually, but it's not exactly... Oh, it's not exactly fast.
They're not all going to fit. It's not all going to fit. Just saying.
Downstairs. 30 seconds.
that's potato peeler. How can I use potato peeler?
It is. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Do I get the answer of how to actually do it?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
A bit of all the potatoes is in there.
Go well.
Don't have to drink it now, do I?
Fantastic performances again. Quite interesting. Maybe you've redeemed yourself there, Jordan. How do you feel?
I definitely have. That's a full bottle. You're ready for your night with that bottle.
Without tools as well.
Without tools. Obviously, good. I think it's fair to say you did get the most potato in your bottle, which is good. Obviously, we had some tools from the other contestants. But one question I want to ask you all is, what did it say on the whiteboard?
You spin me right round. Yeah, you spin me right round, baby, right round.
What did you think that led to?
A hammer.
A hammer?
Yeah.
I didn't see the message.
I tried to actually spin it and it wouldn't actually spin, so it was a bit misleading with that, but yeah.
So there was a hammer on the back of the whiteboard. Yeah. But Jonny, that message wasn't actually about the hammer, was it?
No, if you turned me around, you would have found a knife stapled to my back.
I would have just hurt myself.
There was a knife on your back?
Yeah, there was a knife taped to my back.
Was that why we were in a bin bag? I thought it was just around a concert later.
I think it would have helped you,
but you know, you did all right.
I would have shot my own finger off.
Yeah, I cut myself with the potato peeler.
Yeah.
We're grown adults here, surely that would have happened.
Grown.
Well, clearly not, having to see what you guys do.
Okay, I think it's that time to come bring the scores now.
Yeah.
After what I've seen, I think it's fair to say there's going to be a 4 points order for Jordan. Simply, on the matter as the bottle was very full.
Yeah, definitely. 327
grams. 327
grams.
I'll give you that.
That's a whole potato.
That's good. And obviously they made most of water, as you found out, Jack. That's all you're talking about. Now I've got to give my 1 point the lowest score. I think it's going to have to come to you, Dave.
I knew it was coming.
I'm sorry, mate.
Awful performance.
Task two, absolutely fantastic. Genius there.
Thank you.
Now again, I'm in a tie between Jack and Bex. Maybe it's because you're into similar people.
Who got the potato?
Who made art?
Now, on a purely entertainment value, and that's what I'm going on here, is I'm going to have to give 3 points to you, Jack.
Yes.
And then Bex, that means we're going to have to give you 2.
I sacrificed my jeans for that challenge. There was potato everywhere.
Send them to the washers. So, obviously, now that we've got all the scores, Jonny, what does that mean?
So, thinking of all that together.
Do I know where we're at?
I'm just waiting for it to be tied up for me, and I'm waiting for an answer in my ear.
Let's have a quick recap. On the first round, we gave Bex 4 points. On the second round, we gave Dave 4 points. And third round, 4 points to Jordan.
Unlucky Jack.
Yeah, you did really well, Jack.
Didn't really get that at all, did we?
I think on a pure average.
Yes.
Thinking about the other rounds as well. Bex, I think total, we just got it through now. Bex, absolute winner there.
Yes.
Overall, good.
Doing it for
could have been better, could have been worse. But
definitely
listen,
clear winner.
That's good, wasn't it? That was fantastic. Tasklord, absolutely fantastic. Now, congratulations to Bex on that one. Absolutely proud winner. Now, thank you, everyone. Jonny as well. Thank you all, guys.
We're just happy to have a job.
Nice. Honestly, that was so entertaining. I love that myself. Now, don't forget, we are part of the Great Ride Challenge and we are raising money for charity. That is Mind and Cope with the Cancer. So please do me a favour and head over to greatredchallenge.co.uk/donate.